Reverend Howard Carter, British, I believe, Pentecostal minister, was imprisoned for being a conscientious objector during World War I. You write in your book that while he was in prison, the Lord revealed to him the division and classification of the nine gifts of the Holy Spirit. So what are those divisions?
So the Lord showed him, Reverend Howard Carter, that is, three categories of gifts. Now, there are nine gifts, and so three into three categories. And the three categories are the gifts of inspiration, and those are the tongues, interpretation of tongues, and the simple gift of prophecy. Then you have the revelation gifts. They reveal something. They show something. And those are the discerning of spirits and the word of knowledge and the word of wisdom. Mm. Then you have the ones we like a lot, the power gifts. They do something. And those are the gifts of the gift of faith, the gifts of healing, the working of miracles. Mm. And so I found that God, for my sake, because I'm a simple guy, we're a simple sheep, God breaks things down so we can study them easier. That's why 1 Corinthians 12, Paul starts out by saying, now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I would not have you ignorant. Which tells me right away that ignorance is a choice. Because if ignorance were not a choice, he would not tell me not to be ignorant. James, by the way, tells us that we can ask for wisdom. So wisdom is a choice too. So I can choose to be wise, or if I don't choose to be wise, my only other alternative is ignorance. Now the fact that Paul would have to say, don't be ignorant about spiritual gifts, spiritual manifestations, means that it is possible to be ignorant of spiritual manifestations.
Totally. That's what it says.
On the flip side, because they are gifts, and the Lord spoke this to me through tongues and interpretation in my own prayer life one time. How the Lord said it was that the gifts are already given. Now think about this. Until you give a gift, it is not yet a gift. In order for a gift to be a gift, you would have had to have given it. Mm-hmm. So the fact that we call them gifts are because they've already been given to us.
Yes, that's right. Amen.
Now, you receiving a gift and you unwrapping a gift are two very different things, though.
Mm. Ooh.
Wow.
It's good.